From the United States, for the Armed Forces of the United Nations, the Special Service Division of the War Department presents a delayed broadcast of one of America's most popular radio programs, the Telephone Hour.
It's the Telephone Hour, presenting Joseph Hoffman. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to the Telephone Hour. Our guest soloist is Joseph Hoffman, who appears this evening with Donald Voorhees and the Bell Telephone Orchestra. For his program, Mr. Hoffman has chosen a group of piano solos of the sort that have made his name famous throughout the world and is playing the delight of millions for over half a century. But right now, our program opens with a stirring musical tribute to Red Cross Month as the orchestra plays America. Our guest soloist this evening, Joseph Hoffman, will play first a group of solo pieces. Mr. Hoffman begins with a well-known composition written by his friend and colleague, Sergei Rachmaninoff, Prelude in C-sharp minor. Mr. Hoffman. Thank you. For his next number, Joseph Hoffmann gives us a satirical march, penned in a humorous moment by Sergei Prokofiev, Mr. Hoffmann. It's an interesting sidelight on Joseph Hoffmann's career as an artist to learn that he is also famed for his mechanical inventions, of which more than 60 have been patented. These include a special piano chair, an oil-burning furnace, and a house that rotates with the sun. But Mr. Hoffmann is also an inventor of great music, and his compositions range from symphonic works to short piano pieces. Right now, we're to hear one of the latter group, his Elegy, Joseph Hoffmann. Mr. Hoffmann now adds the gift of his artistry to the familiar and beloved Polonaise by Chopin, the military Polonaise, Joseph Hoffmann. Thank you. When he was 16, Joseph Hoffmann was privileged to become for 2 years the only private pupil of Anton Rubinstein. Toward the end of his studies, young Hoffmann was ordered by the great master to learn within 3 short days his concerto in D minor, one of the most difficult of all Rubinstein's works. The pupil protested, but nonetheless started to memorize the concerto, and on the prescribed date, played the work under the baton of the composer. The success of this performance was so great that the Rubinstein concerto became the number one piece in Mr. Hoffmann's repertoire. In fact, in 1937, when he played at the Metropolitan Opera House, celebrating his 50th year as a recitalist, Joseph Hoffmann was forced by popular acclaim to include this work. Now we're to hear a part of this dazzling composition as Joseph Hoffmann, accompanied by Donald Voorhees and the Bell Telephone Orchestra, plays the thrilling last movement of Rubinstein's concerto in D minor. Mr. Hoffmann. Thank you.
have just heard a delayed broadcast scheduled expressly at this time for the Armed Forces of the United Nations by the Special Service Division of the War Department of the United States of America. This program has been a part of our English language shortwave service.